Yeah, so when I went into the British Museum, it's kind of amazing because you go into this sort of back room and then there is just this room and every shelf is just chock-a-block of these tablets.
They're not pink, though.
They're not bright pink. The other good thing about writing in mud is if you make a mistake, you can just sort of wet it and, like, change it. They dry in the sun. But a lot of the tablets in the British Museum come from Nineveh, which was the Assyrian capital, and that was razed to the ground in a big fire. So those ones are like literally flame roasted. Writing systems that came after that, stuff on papyrus, there's a lot less of it because the elephants get to it.
We've done a few videos like this where these civilizations have this kind of mental block with zero. What was the problem with these civilizations? Why wouldn't they use zero?
Well, zero is a really hard concept because it's this idea that nothing can be something. And this idea that nothing can be something is completely alien to humankind without the kind of conceptual leap. I don't think it's any surprise, I guess, retrospectively thinking about it, that the society that first realised that you can treat nothing as something in a way and do arithmetic with it is India, because India already had this interesting kind of metaphysical kind of religious belief system about nirvana, where nirvana is nothingness. And nothingness is what you want to achieve, so nothingness is a thing. And so after, you know, centuries, if not millennia, of thinking that nothingness is a thing, the mathematical application of that was to realise that maybe this zero can also be a thing, in the same way that one is a thing and two is a thing. What you need to be careful is that some of these civilizations that didn't have the zero, they realized that you need to maybe make a mark for when there's nothing in the column. And also, if you've got an abacus, you realize that when the rod doesn't have any beads, kind of that's a zero. So it's implicit the idea of a zero, but the first people really to say that the digit can be used, kind of all singing, all dancing, number, digit, just like all the others, that was the Indians. It was moving it from a kind of placeholder to realizing that no, it can actually behave really, really well. And even when it appeared in India, it took centuries for people to actually begin to play around with it and realize that, you know, anything times zero is zero, you know, what is anything divided by zero or zero divided by anything. All these are like, these take hundreds of years to work out. Labor, and as a result of that, they actually developed lots of techniques in agriculture and architecture, and they built up from a beginning in the 11th century, two, three centuries later, they had about more than 500 monasteries all across Europe, from the north of the British Isles down to the Mediterranean,